Hey everybody, welcome back to Hand of Fate. I am the Blues 32.
It has been some time since you last sat at the table.
Again, 1 week.
Let us begin again.
Okie dokie.
She waits for you, even now.
Once again, we enter story mode since it's Saturday. And we will be facing the Queen of Skulls. Again.
Come now. The Queen awaits.
Yes, she does. Let's see. Let's go with... Curse of the Lion Prince. Because I said so. Oh, Maze of Traps, definitely. Let's see. I have little need of the noble trader. What are these two really? These'll help. You know, considering what my character is like. My character will get stronger with each battle. So it's best to have as many battle types as I can. Like, Mr. Lionel, I don't think. Let's go instead with... Well, let's just go with the Demon Trader. It's not a thing for battle, but let's go with it anyway. That away and replace it with this. Put this away. Replace it with that. This away and replace it with this. You know, maybe you're curious as to why, and maybe you'll get to see. I have no guarantees. Excuse me. I took my cat to the vet today. He didn't like it. Neither did I, because I found out I'm probably going to spend like $300-some dollars on him.
And us men and women merely players. I alone
not right
do
away.
Not play. I maintain the rules.
Blarp.
You have choices, and I have predestined.
I refuse to offer my blood.
Your choices, though, are merely a rediscovery of that which you already know.
This could be bad. I don't think I thought this through. In regards to my choice in a... choice of a... what's the word I'm looking for here? Bullets! Choice of clasps, that's it. That's the word. No, get away from the body, get away from the body. Nope. I'm used to pressing circle to roll. I'm playing a different game. Balls! Oh gosh, oh gosh. No. See, with each person I kill, I get stronger. And stronger. Now that I think about it, why did I think this was a good idea? That doesn't matter. We can worry about that later. No, thank you. Probably should have read that, sorry. I'm a little distracted. Oh. Good. Let's attempt to get around the creature, even though I failed.
Choose from these options.
Ow.
Each step brings pain.
Oh, please don't lose my
and
shield.
Each moment of pain.
What did I lose? What did I lose?
Suffering. More pain. More darkness.
Oh, I lost the Ring of Hindsight. That's a good ring.
I will happily wager on the outcome. I do not think you have what it takes.
Man, this was really not a good idea. I apologize, folks. I was not thinking clearly. Hey! Now all I had to do was not die. It sounds so simple. No. Ooh. Huh, how about that? I didn't die.
I'm sure you're grateful for that.
That would have been helpful back there. You need gloves if you're gonna open the, excuse me. If you're gonna open...
Sometimes form follows function, and vice versa. In this
the chest
case,
after the
it's
desert
called
cult.
A huge hammer. You take a guess.
Otherwise, you will do permanent damage to your hands.
I bet you're thrilled to see Jack again.
Oh, ecstatic! You have no idea. Jack, buddy, pal. Balls. I'm gonna die. And in such a pitiful manner. Recover from this. Maybe I won't die after all. That's a big maybe. Anyway, you can see why
your
I.
Your currency is spent. Your memory's tattered.
Chose to
torn.
Put the maze in there. Got me a lot of gold
cards
quick.
For us to play with.
Oh, good. More rats. I was worried there wouldn't be enough rats. I mean, I know I put the cards in there myself. For the express purpose of being able to battle them. But, you know, not so many after in a row.
Go!
Cat's gonna be expensive next time around. He's gonna have dental, stuff. Don't think there's gonna be an extraction, but yeah, and that alone's gonna cost $365. I'll have to look at the thing again, but... Doubter attack!
This token will unlock more cards if you can defeat this encounter.
The landlocked lubber is a hive of activity when you return. The sounds of boisterous drinking and frivolity echoing throughout. You'll make your way to the bar to find Carlo, who seems displeased with his upturn in business. You fear the news from the Highbinder will not improve his mood. After hearing the news, he says... Our times indeed, my friend. Not only is that foul beast back in our waters, but I fear that not all my patrons this night are here for my generous hospitality. Later, we've got more than a few bandits and brigands in here than at Bilgewater Stockade. Hope you've got your fighting boots on. More unsavory characters enter through the doors, and an eerie silence spreads across the room. Almost everyone present rises to their feet, although a few obviously have no stomach for the coming fight and bail for the exits.
Excuse me.
One of their number pipes up. Such a shame that such terrible things could happen in such a nice place. If only people knew how to curb their curiosity. If only you didn't know how to take a hammer to the face so well. And by so well, I mean you just... All the bones just break so easily. It's lovely. Tell me, how do you just... have your skull cave in just so perfectly, so symmetrically. Beautiful thing. Once the fighting inside has stopped, you start to think about repairing the damage. Just as you attempt to right the first table, a voice booms from outside. You've meddled with the affairs that are beyond your remit. The Norwich docks are under Mage Council protection, and whatever is happening to our ships is wholly our concern.
Perhaps this time you will best your intellectual superiors. Occasionally, brawn may defeat brains.
We're aware of the owner's obsession with the Kraken, and there's clearly no point in asking you to cease your disruptions. You and your ramshackle tavern shall burn in our righteous fire. Jack, what are you doing here? Though you're absolutely right, there's no point in asking me us to stop. No! Oh! No! How dare you? Hatred is all-consuming. Your skulls remind me of whack-a-mole. Ow! You're wasting me money! You're wasting me money, SpongeBob! When you return inside, you find Carlo hiding under the bar. He obviously fears mages in their power. Cleaning up can wait until tomorrow. You both find a spot by the hearth and enjoy a strong drink. Carlo tells you about the locals in the area and the tale of how he came to fear the Kraken so. This card's token is now yours.
Well, why did he fear the Kraken?
Why does he fear the Kraken so?
Ah, an encounter with the devils of the night. Perhaps fuff. Not your last.
Fuff. You need to be blessed first. Goblins. Being stout and meek, goblins know they cannot use strength or fear to survive. They rely more on mischievous methods. They steal from you when you are asleep and escape through magic portals.
Scavengers of the earth tell... Excuse me.
Tell tales of the hidden vaults that these goblins hide their ill-gotten loot in. Their portals are made by dark magic, unkind to all but themselves.
There's a token in it for you if you win.
One night, you awaken to find your belongings being rifled through by goblins. As soon as they notice you stirring, they run away with your weapon. They also have stolen some of your food and gold. Well, that just won't do. Now I have to kill them. Duo of goblins. Yeah, laugh it up. See if I don't come for you first. Probably shouldn't. Yeah, I won't. I go for you. give me back gold. Not yours. Risking this guy getting away. Come here, you. Blew that horn just a little too late, my friend. Just a smidgen too late. As you prepare to continue your journey, you notice a small figure hiding in the shadows. You pounce on the creature and drag it into the light. Well, well.
Hello, my boy! What a coincidence meeting you here, Mr. Lionel explained sheepishly. Having a spot of goblin trouble?
Mr. Lionel gives a deep sigh, sits back down and says,
Well, funny thing, really, I wanted the crown to blackmail my way back into the city, but it turns out this way is much better.
It goes on to explain how, after learning that a brazen human thief had dared to raid the Goblin King's own treasure vaults, stealing the King's crown no less, he sent word to the King that he could help get it back in exchange for ending his exile.
All I had to do was to greet Erebus guards, find you, and revoke my banishment. While the crown remains stolen, he can continue to rule by default. He needs me to help him make sure that nobody else gets it first. I suppose he'll keep trying to find the crown, but I'm sure you'll deal with his lackeys, eh?
I've waited long enough.
Mr. Lionel produces a horn from his inner pocket, plays a sharp, quick note, and a magical portal appears behind him.
Don't let this world get you down, friend. You never know when luck will go your way.
With that, he grabs his toes, rolls backwards into the portal, and vanishes. This card's token is now yours. Mr. Lionel, ya wankstain. A light draws you to a nearby hilltop where you see a warlock disappear in a cloud of sulfur, leaving behind his summoned minions. Poop nuggets. He's hoping for skulls. They die so easily to the might of my hammer. Nope. Take that back. Your arm. Because I'm pretty sure I just grinded it into paste. Two gain cards. Hooray. Chains of Rage, obviously. What am I thinking?
An excellent way to turn an injury into an asset.
Ah. I was hoping for some food.
Once, many came to play the game. Now,
the devil's so choice.
The bored, the obsessed. The
devil appears in your path.
Some company may need to fill their mind with anything else but their problems.
Oh, what the heck?
I'm here to test your might, so-called hero.
Is that what you're doing?
Choose your foe.
Would be beneficial to deal with that crossbow as a priority.
You're no mighty hero. I will let you live with your choice.
Really hoping he would go with the other one. You know what I mean?
What the...
Oh, you're angering me. Oh, you make me so angry. Knock it off. The devil cries.
You have passed my cunning test. Have some treasure. Perhaps next time our paths cross, I will kill you myself.
The dealer draws you 3 gain cards. Success chance cards reward gold.
Good luck to you.
I think I'll wait.
Are you sure that's the right approach?
Hey! Alright, moving on. Yeah, you know, this one. Are you if you refuse to help out, she will curse you. So, let's not do that. Oh, come on! I just don't understand how the card movement works. Makes no sense to me. Ball sacks! To yourself. Especially you, Mr. Scimitar Man. What in the... upset that I'm bringing back her husband's corpse. And don't you try and tell me that I didn't kill him. You return to the woman bringing her battered husband with you.
Just drop him in the corner and take what you want from his rubbish.
She says, handing you a sack. I think I want this. I am lacking in artifacts. I could use some food. Can't really buy much else due to the curse on me.
What do you got?
Nothing worth my time, anyway. There we go. Moving right along. More rats. Oh, that's not bad. Just four?
Oh, hum. Card that keeps showing up on the left.
Ooh, food. Good deal. No, that's not the right button. Curses. Ah. Well, what does that have to do with anything? No thanks.
Better than trudging along a muddy road, certainly. I hear nothing but the sounds of mourning.
Ah,
she is close.
We've managed to get there. This is good. That was pure luck. I just want to really hit some undead things with my hammer. It's what it's there for. And see how well it works? Down, they stay down.
More health to work with. Much good mate, do you?
Oh, it'll do me much good.
Such strength. If only all problems could be solved with brutality, you would be a champion.
Damn it, I was really hoping
face
not to run into her just
and
yet.
Learn your fate.
A powerful skeleton warrior with the ability to summon a demonic pile of skulls that can create a legion of skeletons. Few necromancers possess the skill or courage to attempt the creation of such a creature. Any misstep during the ceremony could result in a hideously painful death.
Win this and claim my token.
Do this thing. No. Oh, I forgot to throw shit. Go. Wait. You and me, Queenie. Huge hammer.
Then it is done.
Yep.
When even a creature as haunting as the Queen of Skulls perishes, we know the game is almost done. The kings are gathering now.
Where are we getting? For exploring the maze of traps you receive. The scavenger's cap. For defending the landlocked lover, you receive these cards. Landlocked Lover 4. Ghost of the Sea. Help the locals. Talk about some useless cards. For encountering the goblins, you receive a gain 5 food card. Time heals. And goblins. As a reward for defeating my skeleton queen, you receive the Queen of Plague and the Lizard Dome. For defeating my skeleton queen, you receive Arrow Cutter and Mortal Whimsy.
One more round. You have earned it.
I'd say so.
Let us approach the Mother of Plagues.
Ew, let's not. That sounds very unhealthy. Negative aura. Whenever the player loses a curse, they also lose a random item. Challenges the more of the plague cards, but also 5 cursed gambler cards. Excuse me. As the name implies,
under the ground, the filthy rat kind court her favor, murder each other with leprous teeth for the honor of siring her children.
Berserker armor. Wait, no. Medium armor because I don't like it. And replace that with time heals. That is a good, good card. What it? Well, you'll see. Needless to say, though, it's a good card. No crucible, please. Had enough of that the first time. Get rid of these. Don't need them. Lizard Dome. No. No, not the Lizard Dome. Marketplace. And yeah, help the locals, I suppose. Probably not the best idea I've ever had, but whatever.
Banish your curses with caution while facing the queen.
Just cut the cards, man. Why is he always showing off? Okay, I get it. You can make the cards levitate. It's amazing.
You know you risked the true and final death at this table, as I risked my life in ages past.
I think I'll wear that, thank you. What do we got? I'd really, really prefer
all sorts of terrible
not
things live in caves.
Mess with the cursed gamblers.
Sure?
Those are not good cards.
Soon the game will end. I will take your piece from the board. It will be done. Unlike other opponents, I will remember you fondly.
No. No, I will be the one to beat you. And even if I don't, I'll keep trying until I do. See, that's the thing. The game doesn't stop until I give up. And I am filled with determination. Ow! Position. Man, look at all that gold I lost. Hate that guy. Desperate measures, please.
Prepare for bad times, savor the good.
Now, what do we got? Call for. Let's try the Greenboro Forest. I don't quite recall what that is. Let's go for it anyway. Oh, I have a bad feeling about this. Yep. Just what I was afraid of. Really? Before I can go down the ladder, I get attacked. They have nothing better to do but attack me as I try and go down a ladder. Father, stewed again. Yay, game card!
I'm sure you're grateful for that.
Very grateful.
What brings you to play the game?
Ah, ladies and
chest. I know you
chest.
Will not tell me. Like old
I
rest,
alone.
You are silent.
Soldier's training thing. Sucks very much. What can he do, you know? Just useless. Ooh.
A challenge for you, and a token.
You're
if
once
you
again
succeed.
Outside the barracks of the Duke's army. The Sword Liege looks pleased to see you. Exactly the type of bloke I was hoping to see. I'm surrounded by greenhorns that wouldn't recognize deadly combat even if it killed them. I'd love to show them examples of brutal techniques. Will you help me? Sure. We've rounded up some local brigands for you to practice on. You're ready, your weapon. What? The token's mine already?
That is what it means to be king. To return even after defeat.
Oh. Oh. No, 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 no! 1, 2, 3, 4. No, no, no. You don't have to kill him, you just have to build up your combo meter. That will serve as a powerful example to the soldiers. We're not exactly well equipped or well stocked, but our stores will have something of use. Drow will look after you. Please return whenever you are near here. Wow. They weren't kidding when they said they were low on supplies. What was that, 3 gold coins and 1 piece of food? Please bless me.
The gods
Thank
look
you.
Upon you favorably.
Hunting the huntsman.
We play for a token.
Hunt,
now.
Hunt, hunt, it's the huntsman. It turns out that it's not too hard to track down a mad huntsman who has been on a crusade across the countryside in search of a mythical beast. He has been spotted interrogating tavern growers across accosting travelers in the woods and closely scrutinizing various animal droppings. You hear that he recently left the small town of Thatcross and was seen heading into the forest nearby. You follow a set of tracks that lead you into a leafy glade. Colorful autumnal debris blankets the ground. You stop dead when you hear a suspiciously loud snapping sound beneath your feet. Schlarp. Oh, thank God. You catch the edge of the pit with a firm grasp and manage to haul yourself up onto the solid ground. In front of you stands a grizzled veteran hunter, adorned with many trophies from his kills. He moves with calm assurance, but his gaze pierces you like a dagger. I'm impressed that you escaped my trap. In fairness, it was not designed for one such as you, but someone more substantial. Having spent so many years in the role of hunter, it is unusual to find myself as prey. Let us share a drink at the tavern where we can converse like men instead of tracking each other's footprints like beasts. If that's what you want to do, I'm for it.
An expedition. Press on. Did you expect me to tell
no,
your fortune?
No, I don't expect you to tell my fortune. And aw, shite, this is gonna
suck.
They're
most base and despicable when they begin to believe their own
lies. Walking by the ocean at night, you notice that the waves are starting to crash ever more violently and with a thunderous roar.
My powers are
out
genuine.
Of the white cap rushes an angry, malevolent spirit. A howling screech rings in your ears. Another land dweller, oblivious to the dangers of the sea. You do nothing to stop cruelty and violence of the ocean. Until someone claims vengeance for me, I shall wreak mine upon all who idly dwell upon the shore.
The black deck delivers again.
The only way to not get cursed by that is to complete the Kraken quest. Once you've killed the Kraken, which is not an easy task in and of itself, then she will be nice to you, and you can get your token. Prior to that, she will make you regret being born. Fuff. Ow, fuff. Once she's on your side, though, she can give you some really nice stuff.
Just one weapon when you can have them all.
Let's try this. It's a unique card. Let's put it that way. It literally becomes a different weapon each time. Some food. Never hurts to have a little extra food. Unless the food is on fire. Help the locals. Carlo, the barkeep of the landlocked lubber, has introduced you to the new Hollow Watch. They help protect a vast area of woods that have become home to many of the people displaced by the chaos of the land. They have many problems that you might be able to assist with. The gods do smile upon us here today. Some mages have constructed a shrine to the cloaked devil that spreads disease and anger across our land. We have no one strong enough to withstand a curse that will be handed down to the shrine destroyer. Perhaps you have the curse to see. Perhaps you have the strength we seek in our hour of need.
More than anything, I am proud of my array of curses.
I hate you so much. Oh, no.
horse is a fine companion. I'm sure you'll need this one in time. You do not seem to have the temperament for friends, even in the animal kingdom.
Approach the shop. Damn well said so. I hope I don't do this twice.
I prefer not to play at chance. I only contend with the most serious of games.
In an old tavern at the edge of a dark forest, you meet a gambler. Care to try your luck at the cards? He asks with a wicked gleam in his eye. He grins diabolically at you as you sit down, making one easy. The stakes are this. If you win, I'll give you something from my collection of magical items. If I win, then I'll curse you instead.
A choice. Select your desire.
Balls. Does this one do? Fine.
Ah. That is one of my favorites.
No, I don't want to play another round. What are you, nuts?
Again, a token is at stake.
You return to the landlocked lobby to see what Carlo has in mind next. It is hard to tell mages and bandits had besieged the place. It looks just as decrepit and ramshackle as usual. Carlo greets you warmly. There is only so much we can find out about our aquatic nemesis from dry land. Our next action must take place upon the sea. I've been comparing the information you found at Nullwich Port with the Highbinders, and I may have a plan. Carlo gestures you towards a collection of papers and charts that are spread across two tables. If the bar had patrons, this might be problematic, but as usual, the only occupants are an aquaphobic soldier, sailor, and yourself. The nearby port of Eastersea, far more respectable, has trading routes that I believe follow a similar path and time as the smugglers. I think if we can get you aboard a ship, then you'll have a front row seat to the scariest show in the land. Maybe. I doubt it. That'll do. All right. Moving right along.
Better than trudging along a muddy road. Certainly.
Are you freaking kidding? Game? What the deuce? No. Didn't you really just say ow? There we go. That went pretty good. Only lost 10 points of health. Did I get anything out of that? Ah. Good deal.
I can hear her summoning her children. This fight will be bloody.
Didn't expect to reach the end so quickly. Another shop? Two shops in a row, huh? That's different.
It's often hard to determine the provenance of an artifact, but this cleaver was clearly forged after the first invasion.
If I'm gonna be fighting the Queen of Plague, I might as well equip the weapon designed for her kind, eh? Now I just need to find her.
More rats, more swarms.
More rats, more problems. They weren't kidding about this being a swarm. Look at them all. Your filthy, disease-ridden carcass away from me. One food.
I'm sure you are grateful for that.
What's this do? No.
Every tool a mage can create may be used against them.
That'll
as pleases do. You.
And more food. Aha! No, I'm not
going to. Take your feelings and turn them into power.
I know.
I worked long and hard to make that particularly painful.
This could be bad.
Ingenious, don't you think?
But probably not. I refuse your wager. Why wager anything when I can just kill everybody here? You know? Way I see it. Sorry about the AC, folks. I hate summer. Why did I have to be born in the summer? Wow, 10 food. Well, so much for delivering
combat,
that guy's
even
stuff.
I have waited to see. Majestic.
Queen rats of great skill with their spears and are accompanied by a totem that spreads their toxic, damaging filth. It really does. And they shoot these weird blasts at you. It's very strange. Watch and see. Oh, my magic whatsoever protected me. Actually, I think it's because I have the retribution thing on. Because of that, they get stunned afterwards. Ah, come on, keep it up. Yes, I can kill her this way. And I intend to. She deserves it.
You display marvelous dexterity for one who seems such an oaf.
Still need to take care of her nest thing. That's not a problem. Boink. Not bad. A two for this week.
The rat kind will not easily recover from this loss. A million half-orphaned rats will fall upon you like a tide of horror. Why did you still play? Why can't you walk away? You have earned your prize.
Because I
today.
Don't want to die. For helping to train the Duke's men, you receive this card. For escaping the Huntsman's trap, you receive the Mug and Barrel. Planning with Carlo gains you the following card: Sea Journey. Biggest pain in the ass of them all. You need to get like four successes in a row. It's insane. As a reward for defeating my Ratman Queen, you receive Thunderstrike, Heavy Armor, Emperor's Jewel, King of Skulls, Shop, and Fire in the Deep.
I have only begun to challenge you.
Next up, King of Skulls and whatever that thing is, a medallion, I guess. Till then, I'm the Blues 32. This is Hand of Fate. TTFN. Ta-ta for now.